हाय बरकातहू, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास स्टूडेंट्स। क्लास सिक्स सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन। सो विल बी लर्निंग टुडे, वी हैव डन विथ 9.1 एक्सरसाइज, फर्स्ट मेन एंड सेकेंड मेन, थर्ड मेन आई एम गोइंग टू डू। बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू लर्न व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय इक्विवेलेंट रेशियोज। इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू लर्न अबाउट दिस रेशियो स्टूडेंट्स, which are byproducts of simplest form of ratios. Already you have learned the simplest form, how to convert the ratios to simplest form. How can we do it that? An example would make the concept clear. Just take an example here. Ratios 30 is to 20 and 24 is to 16 are equivalent. When solved, they both yield a simplest form. Yield means the answer what we get. Simplest form. How is that possible? Let us see. 30 is to 20. When we are doing to simplest form, we are just writing in fraction form. I have said you already the three forms of writing the ratios. The third form was fraction form. That is 30 by 20. 0, 0 get cancels and 3 by 5 is the answer. 3 by 2 is the answer and the ratio is 3 is to 2. And next part, what is this? We have the next number 24 and 16. The same thing I am taking in fraction, 24 and 16. I am converting this to simplest form. That is 2 ones are and 2 twos are, 2 eights are. 12 and 8 is the first simplest form I got. Next, see these numbers. Can it be converted to still simplest form? Are they having any common factor? Yes, they are having the common factor. That is 4 from 4 tables. It get cancels. It get divides by 4 tables. That is 4 threes and 4 twos are. Are we not getting the same answer, students? That is 3 is to 2 and 3 is to 2. So, are these numbers equivalent? Yes, they are equivalent to each other. So the basic ratio is the same for both the ratios. That is 3 is to 2 is the answer we got. So we can tell that they are equivalent to each other. We can get equivalent ratio how? By dividing. See, I divided here, right? By dividing or by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the same numbers. That is the same numbers. I have said you, I have explained you in fractions also what are equivalent fractions. The same way here we have to divide or multiply the numerator as well as the denominator by the same number. You have understood about the equivalent ratios, no students? Yes. So the third mean, page number 114. Write two equivalent ratios for each of the following. The first number there, the first ratio given for you is 3 is to 5. So what is the first step to convert it into the equivalent ratios? Yes, multiply or divide the number. That is, first step is taking into fraction form. That is 3 by 5. I have multiplied into 2. Into 2, I'll get 6 by 10. If I convert that into simplest form, that is 2 threes are and 2 fives are. Am I not getting 3 by 3 is to 5 again? Yes. The next fraction, that is, they are telling you to find two equivalent ratio. The same number, first equivalent ratio we got 6 is to 10. Next equivalent ratio, the first number we multiplied was 2. Next I am multiplying with 3. That is 3 by 5 into the numerator into 3 and the denominator also into 3. I get 9 by 15. If I form into simplest form again, if I cancel, 3 threes are 9, 3 fives are 15. I am getting 3 by 5, that is in ratio 3 is to 5. So the equivalent ratios of this number is 3 is to 5 is 6 is to 10 and 9 is to 5. You can find number of equivalent ratios. That is, again multiply into 4, again multiply into 5, you will be getting equivalent ratios. Second one they have given, 21 is to 31. I have done the sums. Please do it. We will move to fourth main. That is, find out the ratio between the cost of a pencil and that of a pen when pencils cost rupees 24 per score and pens cost rupees 16.80 paisa per dozen. You know, students, dozen means what? Dozen means 12 items. One score here means 20 items. They have given the hint for you in your textbook itself. Dozen means 12 items and one score means 20 items. We have to find out the ratio between the cost of pencil and that of pen. So what is the cost of one pencil? Here they have given rupees 24. So what rupees 24 per square? Per score here it is 20 items. So I have taken divided by 20. So if I found the simplest form, that is 4 6 are 24, 4 5 are 20. If I divide the number, I will be getting 1.20, that is rupees 1.20 paisa is the cost of one pencil. Now we have to find the cost of one pen. So what is the cost here they have given? It is given rupees 16.80 paisa. Per dozen, that is 12, I have taken divided by 12. If I divide this number, I will be getting 1.40. So here, the last step here, we have to find the ratio of pencil and that of a pen. So what is the ratio of pencil we got? 1.20. And ratio of pen what we got? We got 1.40. If I found to the simplest form again here, 00 get cancels. And here, 2 6 are 12 and 2 7 are 14. If I remove, this is in decimal form. See, if I convert this decimal form, if I replace this point here, so here I will be getting 1, 2. See, if I am replacing, so this point is replaced again here. Again, this zeros will be cancelled because after point, if we write how many number of zeros also, it doesn't have any value. I read this as 1.20. I don't read it as 1.20. If I am reading as 20, it manners that it gives some value to the number. But here, after point if we are adding, it does not give any value to the number. How many ever zeros if we add? So here if I replace also, 2 zeros will be done, that will be cancelled. So 2 6 are and 2 7 are. So here we got the answer 6:7. So fifth main here is compare the following ratios. So first one they have given 7:9 and 10:12. So here students, 7:9 and 10:12. First step here is write it in fraction form. That is 7/9 and 10/12. So we don't have the same numerators here. So I am taking the LCM. I got the LCM of 9 and 12 as 36. So I have explained you in fraction how to convert into the equivalent fraction and take out the same numerator and then just add or do ascending order or descending order. Everything is being explained in fractions. The same thing here, we have the first fraction, that is 7 by 9. Observe the LCM, that is 36. So 9 is, when we divide 36 by 9, what is the number we get? It is 9. 4s are 36. So I am multiplying the numerator as well as denominator into 4 and into 4. I get 28/36. Next fraction is 10 and 12. So if I divide 12/36, what is the number I get? That is 12 3s are 36. So I am multiplying with the same number, that is denominator and numerator with the same number, into 3. Why into 3? Because 12 3s are 36. 12 3s are 36. We have taken the LCM of 9 and 12 and we are rationalizing the denominator of both fractions. We are now rationalizing the denominators of both fractions and we got this answers, that is 28/36 and 30/36. Now, the equivalent fraction, are they not equivalent fraction now? See, the numerators are same now. Numerators are same, that is 28 and 36, 28 by 36 and 30 by 36. After rationalizing these numbers, we got the final answer, this one. The numerators are same. Now we can compare the fractions now. So 28 is lesser than 30. So here 30 by 36 is greater than 28 by 36. We can write the final answer. 7 by 9 is lesser than 10 by 12. We have rationalized this one. The next sum here is 3 is to 5 and 5 is to 7. The same thing I have taken the LCM. First step is write it in the fraction form. Next take the LCM of 5 and 7. I got 35. Then rationalize the denominator of both the fractions. And we get the final answer, that is 21 by 35 and 25 by 35. Now the equivalent fractions, these are the equivalent fractions now. So compare it, which is the greater and which is the less. So here you have in fifth main, you have four problems, students. I have done only two problems. The rest two problems, you can do it in your class, you can do it in your rough note. No need to do it in your classwork. That is just a practice for you. Now we'll be moving to sixth main. Sixth main here, the present age of mother is 60 years. And the present age of her daughter is 35 years. Find out the ratio of the first. What we have to find out is the present age of daughter to that of her mother. What is the present age of daughter? That is 35. To that of mother. Mother is how many years old? She is 60. So 35 is to 60. If I cancel it into the simplest form, I'll get 7 is to 12. Next B mean. The present age of mother to the age of daughter. We have to find the ratio between the present age of mother. What is the present age of mother? It is 60 years. Present age of mother is 60 years. To that of age of daughter, when the daughter is 70 years. So present age of daughter is 35. We have to find the age of this people when daughter is 70. So 35 into 2 we get 70. That is twice the age of daughter. So obviously we should take twice the age of mother also. That is into 2. 60 into 2 if I do, I'll get 160. And so 120. And 35 into 2 if I do, I'll get 70. So 120 is to 70. If I cancel the zeros, we will get 12 is to 7. This is important, students. Try to understand this sum very carefully. Third mean, the age of mother to that of her daughter, 20 years from the present time. So 20 years plus 20 you should do for mother as well as for daughter. So what is the present age of mother? It is 60. What is the present age of daughter? It is 35. So 60 plus 20 if I do, I'll get 80. 35 plus 20 if I could do, I'll get 55. So we got the ratio, that is 80 is to 55. Now we have to do it into the simplest form. That is 16 and 11 is the answer, students. Complete third main, fourth main, fifth and sixth main in your classwork.